In the last section, we spoke about constructor functions defined on classes. We also went through a little bit of a shortcut on assigning a property straight through the constructor without having to add any additional function code to the constructor itself. So in this section, we're going to do a quick review on what just happened, just to make sure that it's really crystal clear, because this abbreviated syntax right here of initializing a property name directly from the constructor is something that you're going to see all throughout this course and in a tremendous amount of documentation on Dart as well. So let's get to it. I put together a quick diagram to help you understand what is going on. And the first thing I want to remind you about is that you and I added a function to the class. The function's name was person with a capital P. Because that function name was absolutely positively identical to the class's name, it became the constructor function for this class automatically. Remember, a constructor function gets called automatically any time that it's been defined on the class, and it is our place to do some initialization or setup of the class instance. Inside this constructor, we specified an argument list with exactly one argument on it. Inside that argument list, we wrote out this.firstName. This means that in order for us to create a new instance of a person, we have to call newPerson and provide exactly one argument to it. So specifically because we wrote out an argument right here, that means anytime we create a new instance of a person, we have to provide one argument as well. Now the interesting thing about that argument that we listed there was that on the front of the argument name, we put on this dot, and then we wrote out a property name or the name of a property or field that belongs to this class. Because we followed that strict rules, or because we have this dot and then exactly the field name right here, Dart decided to automatically take this argument of string Steven right here, or whatever your name is in your case, and automatically assign it to the first name property for us. So again, specifically because we used this dot and then the exact name of the property, this got assigned to the correct property name for us. To give you a very quick demonstration of exactly how that worked, I'll flip back over to Dartpad over here. Now I want to find that constructor function, and I'm going to try changing first name right here to something else, like maybe something like my first name. And when I do so, you'll notice that I've got an error message down here. It says my first name isn't a field on the enclosing class. However, if I remove the this dot from this thing, then you'll notice that the error message goes away. So it's specifically the combination there of putting this dot and the exact property name that allows us to take this shortcut in adding this property to the class person. So I'm now going to revert that back to this dot first name. And now my code is going to work as it did before, exactly as we expect. Okay, so again, in this section, we spoke about constructors and we spoke about this little shortcut right here for assigning fields to an instance of a class whenever we call the constructor function. And we call that constructor function by using the new keyword right here and then referencing the class's name. So now that we've got a good overview on this, let's continue in the next section where we're going to start working on our next project that's going to heavily involve classes. So quick break, and I'll see you in just a minute.